Currently, with the onset of quite strong cold weather, the question of heating the greenhouse arises sharply: how to heat it with minimal costs. An interesting option is heating the greenhouse with candles. Often faced with this, it seems like a simple and silly idea to warm the greenhouse with candles, but on the other hand, there are such cases. We started to study this in more detail, and in principle, there is a certain sense in it. Let's delve into it. The point is that there are two types of candles, paraffin and wax. We'll take a closer look at paraffin candles because, first, they are cheaper, the fuel is more affordable, and second, for us as greenhouse growers, when burning, they emit CO2 and water, the products that plants need. Therefore, it's a very interesting and good option for the greenhouse. What's the catch? In fact, paraffin, when burning, releases more heat than gasoline. If gasoline releases 44 megajoules when 1 kilogram of fuel burns, paraffin releases 48, making it even more calorific. So, the fact that heating a greenhouse with candles is possible, and it's quite effective, but there's a nuance. The cost of all this: firstly, a regular candle, taking a classic candle as we understand it, emits 40-60 watts when burning. Now let's calculate how many of these candles we need to light to heat a greenhouse measuring 3 by 6 meters, 17 square meters. It will be 15 degrees Celsius outside, covered with film. We need approximately 5 kilowatts of thermal energy to have plus 15 to plus 18 degrees Celsius inside the greenhouse, depending on the covering. If we have a 40-60 watt candle, then we need to light around 100 candles in the greenhouse to make it warm. They will burn there for some time and provide a certain amount of heat. The nuance here is that paraffin is not always pure, there is a certain percentage of soot, and if we constantly burn it, this soot must settle somewhere. If these candles are just burning in an open greenhouse, we will quickly fill our greenhouse with smoke, this soot must settle. There are very interesting ideas about heating with candles, such as when a small ceramic pot is placed on top. It heats up, providing heat, and all the smoke and dirt accumulate inside this pot. The second point, of course, is that paraffin used for candles is significantly more expensive than other fuels. For example, if we take gasoline, paraffin will be more expensive. True, technical paraffin is much cheaper, but that's a slightly different story, in principle. If you come up with a candle the size of a bucket, with an adequate wick, and make some ceramic container on top that heats up and gives off all the heat, then the idea makes sense. However, in reality, using candles to heat a greenhouse has its challenges, primarily in terms of quantity and where all the soot will go. My opinion is that this direction is not well developed. There is an opportunity to create interesting and effective burners that can heat greenhouses. We can implement a small heating system for the greenhouse, and in case of frost, for example, when we know that there will be a severe frost at night, we can create heaters using paraffin in the form of candles. They will heat the greenhouse throughout the night, allowing us to harvest a good crop in the end. By the way, share your ideas and suggestions in the comments regarding heating with candles or any other alternative heat sources. Let's explore ways to achieve cost-effective greenhouse heating. I believe it will be interesting and beneficial for everyone. Perhaps something innovative might come out of this discussion. With you is Alexander from ECO Greenhouse, live in harmony with nature and in the rhythm of progress.